going on, everyone? Welcome to another episode on Let's Talk About Us with Uche. I am your host, Uche. Thank you very much for joining us today. People who have been following me, thank you so much for your continued support. If you're new to my podcast, please make sure to download, subscribe, share with your friends and family. If you're new to my YouTube, please also make sure to subscribe and don't forget to hit that bell notification so anytime I upload a video, you'll be the very first to be notified. Thank you so much. So, unless you've been living under a rock, you probably already know what's going on. DaBaby is trending for all the fuckery out there, man. So, a few days ago, I'm guessing this happened within this past few days, or maybe a week ago, DaBaby went viral for having a really fucked up comment during one of his concerts. I think the concert was happening here in Texas, somewhere here in Texas. I may be wrong, but my understanding is probably somewhere here in Texas, where he was talking about telling his fans to turn their flashlights on their phone if they don't have no HIV AIDS, if they don't have no AIDS or any disease, I'll kill them in 2 to 3 weeks, to turn their flashlights on. And the fellas, if you're not sucking dick in the parking lot, to turn their lights on.
You didn't show up today with HIV, AIDS, any of them deadly sexual transmitted diseases that'll make you die in 2-3 weeks, put a cell phone light in the air. Lady, if your pussy smell like water, put a cell phone light in the air. Fellas.
Lights up.
Fellas, if you ain't sucking nigga dick in the parking lot, put your cell phone lights
in
the air.
Let's be real about this shit.
Yeah, keep it fucking real.
Some of y'all niggas suspect as a motherfucker, let's be real.
Okay, when I first heard this video, when I first heard about this news, naturally I just rolled my eyes, you know, because first thing first, I am not surprised. Okay, I'm really not surprised at all. And to be honest with you, when I hear things like this and I hear people are being surprised, I'm surprised people are surprised. I've kind of talked about how I feel about Hollywood, not just Hollywood, but like the entertainment industry before. In some of my previous podcast episodes, when I talked about war against spirituality, I'm not surprised at all. This is what we get for putting a bunch of clowns and illiterate motherfuckers on a pedestal. A bunch of no talent having ass. You know, a lot of these motherfuckers ain't got no talent. I'm just keeping it real. You know, some of the artists out there do have talent. You know, but some of these people don't have any type of talent. They just capitalize off selling, you know, sex and selling, talking about violence, selling drugs, selling sex, selling violence, selling misogyny, selling thuggerism, niggerism, selling all kinds of buffoonery. That's basically what they're capitalizing off of. But I've kind of also talked about this too. I can't really blame them. You know, apparently this is what people want to hear. So they are going to keep supplying what people want to hear, supply and demand. So I understand it's a smart business move. I get it. But from a very personal perspective, am I surprised that DaBaby made these homophobic, inaccurate comments about HIV AIDS? I'm not surprised. And I truly can't even pretend to be surprised. But I wanted to take this opportunity to address some of the problematic things that he said about HIV AIDS. As people probably already know, HIV and AIDS are used interchangeably, even though they're not necessarily the same thing. HIV is the virus. It's a virus that, you know, when you contract it, if it's not treated after a while, it turns into AIDS, you know. And it depends on your immune system. It could, for most people, it will take years, maybe 2 years, maybe 3 years, maybe 5 years, maybe 10 years before it turns to AIDS. But AIDS is the disease that HIV infection turns into if left untreated, if you're not treated. So you can have HIV without having AIDS. I don't know if I'm making sense. You can be HIV positive and not have AIDS. But the words, the definitions are used interchangeably because one can lead to the other. So HIV and AIDS are used interchangeably. It will not kill you within 2 to 3 weeks. That is bullshit. HIV or AIDS will not kill you within between 2 to 3 weeks. After contraction, it may actually take up to 3 weeks before it actually shows up in your blood. But the actual infection itself takes a while, okay? Before you start, some people, well, it depends on your immune system. Some people can start noticing symptoms in less than a year. Some people may start noticing symptoms after years of infection. Again, this depends on healthcare, quality of living, immune system, and, you know, access to healthcare and all that good stuff. HIV/AIDS, unfortunately, is... it's a disease that's being associated with queer men, specifically gay men or men who sleep with other men. This is also false. Yes, within the gay community, gay men, especially gay men of color, most especially gay black men, are most susceptible to HIV. This is not necessarily because of, you know, HIV is God's curse on gay men for sleeping with other men or any of that jargon that your pastor or your family members are probably preaching. That's nothing but bias and bullshit. I feel like I'm gonna make an entire episode dedicated to that, why HIV is most prevalent within the LGBTQ, specifically black men. A lot of it has to do with poor education, lack of access to healthcare, and also ostracization from family and society as a whole. Like I said, I feel like I'm gonna make a whole episode on that and break it down. But unfortunately, you have some coon motherfuckers today who still think that HIV/AIDS is synonymous to just gay, which is bullshit. Anyone can get HIV unless you're one of the few people who are immune to the virus, which your chances of being one of those people is very slim, because those people are very little in number. So more than likely, you're not one of those people unless you're one of those people who are actually immune to the HIV virus. Literally anyone can catch HIV. Black, white, male, female, gay, straight, everything else in between. You are not exempt. For the most part, most people are not exempt from this virus. And as of today, there are over 1 million people living with HIV in America alone. Over 1 million people. And not all these 1 million are men. Not all of them are gay. Not all of them are gay men. Some of them are women. Some of them are heterosexual women. Some of them are heterosexual men, like actual heterosexual men. Not the, you know, self-proclaimed heterosexuals, because people be like, I'm straight. Yeah, okay, yeah, sure. I'm Chinese. No tea, no shade. Yes, out of the population of over 1 million people who actually have HIV in America, some of them are straight men. Some of them are straight women. Okay. And out of those over 1 million population in America who have HIV/AIDS or HIV, about 13% of them do not know their status. My guess is a lot of those 13% are actually straight people, specifically straight men. It's really unfortunate. Matter of fact, in my travels, I've met a couple of straight men who have never tested for HIV before in their life. They fuck around. They fuck anything, any woman that moves. You know what I'm saying? They raw dog a woman. Matter of fact, that's one of the perks of traveling. You hear a lot of strangers share a lot of deep, intimate adventures from their travels. You know, I remember when I was in New Zealand, I had this dude talk about him and his friend. They raw dogged this girl in New Zealand, and he's never tested for HIV. And he's not the only one. A lot of people, a lot of straight men that I've talked to who have had unprotected sex have never tested for HIV, because there's this assumption that HIV is only for gay men. If you do not sleep with men, it basically means that you are exempt from HIV, which is false. Okay. So my guess is a lot of those 13%, yes, some may be gay, some may be bisexual, but a lot of them are probably heterosexual men and women. So that is misinformation. I just wanted to address that, because there's a lot of stigma around HIV and AIDS, even within the LGBTQ community. I think it's fucked up. Sometimes you see it on Grindr, no positive, saying something along the lines that they don't want to have anything to do with somebody who is HIV positive and things like that. I think it's really fucked up. You know, again, I'm going to be addressing this, the whole HIV AIDS within the LGBTQ community, on a different podcast, not today. I feel like that's a whole dedication on itself, not right now. Another thing I wanted to talk about is also, I feel like this viral sensation thing going on with DaBaby exposes homophobia within the black community. I think it's really fucked up seeing people like DaBaby and even T.I. backing him. I think I saw a screenshot of a comment on Instagram where T.I. or Tip, I think it prefers to be called Tip now, saying that if Lil Nas X can flaunt his gayness, DaBaby should be able to flaunt it. Lil Nas X is not offending anybody. He's not shitting on heterosexuality. He's just expressing himself, you know. And I have my own opinions about Lil Nas X. I feel like I'm gonna get into that on a different episode, but not today. But the homophobia in the black community is very fucking disgusting, and it's very sad and heartbreaking. I think it's both sad and laughable for very obvious reason, and for people who are probably confused as to why it is obvious. The black community, we are still minorities in America, okay? We are the most hated, the most disrespected, the most overlooked, the most underrepresented race in America, okay? For centuries, we've been marginalized. We've been fighting so hard for freedom, for equality, even till today. Almost every year, I swear, almost every year, there's some type of march about Black Lives Matter this, Black Lives Matter that. And I've kind of shared my opinion about the whole Black Lives Matter ordeal in the past. I respect the Black Lives Matter movement, but unfortunately, I feel like the average black person does not fully understand what Black Lives Matter fully entails, like the entirety of it. It doesn't make any sense that we as ethnic minorities, as in like the most hated, the most overlooked, the most disrespected, we're here fighting for equality, fighting for justice, and on the other hand, we are shitting on another group of minorities. That makes no fucking sense whatsoever. Me personally, I can never in a billion years understand what two grown adults do in the privacy of their home, as long as it's legal, between both of them, bother somebody else. It doesn't make any sense to me, okay? I don't walk around wondering what my coworkers are doing with their spouses at home. I don't walk around Walmart imagining what people at Walmart are doing back in their homes. That has nothing to do with me, okay? Literally every day, I have the opportunity to maximize my potential as a human being because I know the clock is literally ticking. I could die any moment. I don't know when I'm gonna die. My goal on earth is to maximize my potential and live my best life until I stop living it. I don't understand why I would even think of stopping or slowing down that living my life process in order for me to look into somebody else's personal life. That makes no sense. It's sort of like driving on the freeway. Instead of looking your way, looking into your lane, focusing and looking straight, you're looking over your left and your right, looking at the people driving right next to you. Of course, your dumbass is going to crash because you are not prioritizing yourself. You are not paying attention into your life. You decided to pay attention to somebody else's life. I cannot understand it. I would not understand it. And I'm really glad. I do want to also say shout out to all the people who checked him. You know, some of the celebrities checked him. I think Dua Lipa, I think that's her name. You know, she came out and she put a statement out. I know Elton John did speak out. A few other celebrities did speak out. Shout out to every single one of those celebrities that did speak out against this injustice. And also pay attention to all the quote unquote pro-gay artists, especially the female ones, okay? Miss Barbie things, okay? Pay attention to some of them that stayed quiet. They stay silent throughout these commotions. That shows you who really is with the LGBTQ community and who is just trying to capitalize off your desperation, okay? When all of y'all sucking their dicks and worshiping some of these coon ass celebrities, when it gets down to something that has to do with your community as a queer man or woman and they're silent because there's no money to be made, I hope you guys are paying attention to that too, okay? Because yeah, apparently some of y'all don't have no jobs. It feels like some of y'all don't have no jobs. You know, if some of these celebrities follow somebody, you'd be the first to report. If somebody unfollows somebody, you'd be the first to report. If they use the bathroom, you'd be the first to report. I hope you paid attention to some of these quote unquote pro-gay artists who are staying silent in a time like this when somebody, a clown like DaBaby, is spreading false narrative about HIV/AIDS and the queer community. Like I said, I'm really glad some celebrities did step out and check him. Kudos to all those people. I think some brands that he was working with also dropped him. And I noticed after he was dropped and dragged all throughout Twitter and the internet, he came out and, You know, they should have some mush mouth apology. You know how it is, man. When people get caught slipping, they start coming up with some tattoo tears and, you know, fake ass apology. And, you know, we all know that shit is not genuine at all. That, you know, for him to boldly say something like that in public and not give a shit, that really speaks truth as to how he really feels. Okay, so I'm not buying the apology at all. And also, one thing I did find interesting is how he tried to tie in the whole George Floyd murder, you know, Black Lives Matter movement into this fuckery. Child, please. I notice a lot of artists, a lot of Black artists like to do this shit. You know, a lot of times when they're being under investigation, when the internet is on their case, all of a sudden they want to play helpless and victim. You know, if it's women, they want to play a poor Black woman, or if it's a Black man, you know, Black Lives Matter bullshit. Please, I'm not buying that shit. It is what it is, to be honest with you. But again, this goes back to what I've been saying. We need to be careful the people we put on a pedestal, okay? These, unfortunately, people like DaBaby, unfortunately, are some of the people who represent Black culture, okay? I went through some of his music, some of his music lyrics. None of that shit is godly. None of that shit, I'm not saying that I'm godly. None of that shit is motivational. None of that shit is pumping positivity into the Black community. All I see is, you know, suck my dick this and let me fuck without a rubber and some shit like that. I think I was able to find two songs that he did with Meg Thee Stallion. Very erotic, very explicit. But again, we make passes for this. We make passes for this kind of behavior because it's a heterosexual man, allegedly, Chad. Because, okay, half these niggas be fucking on the low. Okay, let's just keep that real. They're not going to say it to you because, you know, their money will run dry. If you know what I know, half these men in Hollywood are not as straight as they try to make it look, okay? But that's a whole nother conversation. But yeah, the double standard is really sad and fucked up. You know, it's really fucked up that some of the A-list celebrities get away with all kinds of fuckery. You know, they get to say whatever the fuck it is they feel like saying, you know, all kinds of nefarious shit, you know, shoot a nigga in the head, eat my pussy, lick my ass crack or some shit. I've listened to some lyrics, man. I'm like, how the fuck is this shit legal? Like, it makes no fucking sense. But yeah, I stand these people. Yeah, I worship them. But then when it comes to anything gay, especially Black and gay or Black and queer, yeah, I want to start, you know, throwing your pitchforks and shit and try to throw stones and shit. Because for some reason, that's too unacceptable. Anyway, to wrap this up, I wanted to use this opportunity to talk about the whole DaBaby debacle. I'm not surprised. I'm not a fan of DaBaby, but I'm not surprised. You know, these people, this is basically what happens when we put a bunch of illiterate clowns on a pedestal to represent our community, and sadly at that. And I also wanted to use this opportunity to talk about HIV/AIDS and educate people. HIV/AIDS is not a gay disease. Literally anybody can catch HIV, except if you're one of the very few exceptions who are immune to the virus, but your chances of being one of those people is extremely low. I'm gonna try to Google and see how many percentage of the population is actually immune to the HIV virus, but it's very little, so little that you may not get lucky. Okay, literally anybody, Black, white, male, female, gay, straight, everything in between, you can catch HIV. And a lot of people who have HIV are not gay or not queer. They're not part of a queer community. And like I mentioned, over 1 million people are infected with HIV. And out of those 1 million, approximately 13% do not know their diagnosis. And not all of those people are gay, okay? Some of them are straight men and women. So get tested. That little cough, okay, that little sore throat, it may not be coronavirus, child. It may be HIV, okay? But you're probably in denial because, you know, you're diving in that pussy. Like, yeah, cool ass be saying, child. But anyway, stay informed, stay educated, and stay safe, okay? Everybody, including straight people, because anybody can catch the virus. This is the end of today's episode. Please let me know what you think. Do you think DaBaby was out of pocket for saying that? Do you think he was being deliberate? He meant what he said, and there's no apology to take that back? Do you think that was a clear act of homophobia? And if you don't agree with me, please make sure to share your thoughts down below. I really do want to read and see people's perspectives. Again, like I've always said, maybe I'm the one with my head screwed backward. I really do want to understand. I'm a thinker. I'm very curious, and I'm always up for learning. You know, I like any opportunity for me to take in new information information. So please make sure to share your thoughts down below. Like and share with your friends and family. Please also make sure to subscribe, and please do not forget to hit that bell notification if you're new here. Please make sure to follow me on social media, Facebook and Instagram, Let's Talk with Uche. My email is letstalkwithuche@gmail.com. My website is letstalkaboutus.org. Thank you very much. Until next time. Bye-bye.